Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. This is the second video on the series of initial and final values, and in this video we'll be solving or discussing example 8.2 solved in the book. Now let's just revise the concept of time. Although I strongly recommend that you watch my previous video on the subject, so this will be more clear. Anyway, when we say t is equal to 0, that means this is the time when we are where we are standing right now. So anything before this will be called t less than 0, and anything after this time will be called t greater than 0. For convenience, t greater than 0 is divided into again two parts. One is called t greater than 0, which is the transient portion, and the other is called t is equal to infinity, when the circuit becomes fully settled or stable. So this transient period is very important, you have to keep in mind. In addition to this, there are two times which bother students. The first is t0 minus. So this is the time slightly before t is equal to 0. So this time is called t0 minus. And then there is another time just slightly after t is equal to 0. This time is called t0 plus. Now why these two times are important is that when we are dealing with the inductor or capacitor, then we can say that we know that the inductor current does not change instantaneously. So whatever is the current at t0 minus, same current will be present at t0 plus. Similarly, whatever the capacitor voltage does not change instantaneously, that means whatever is the capacitor voltage at t0 minus, same voltage will be at t0 plus. But this is not the case for resistance. The resistance values will change instantaneously. Now in the problem solving, the problems are generally divided into three parts. The first part is we have to find IL0 plus, VC0 plus and VR0 plus. So we'll solve this at t greater than 0, so somewhere here we'll solve this. But the important point is that we can take help of whatever is the value at t0 minus. So we see that. Then is the another part, or part B, where you have to find didt. The didt is also in the transient part. And the third part of the question is generally that we have to find values at infinity. So at t is equal to infinity, where the circuit has become stabilized. Now in this region, the inductor will be short circuited and the capacitor will be open circuited. Similarly, in this region also, the inductor will be short circuited and capacitor will be open circuited. But during the transient period, there will be no short circuit or open circuit. Now let's see the example number 2. As I mentioned, there are three parts here, these three parts, and this is the circuit. So first of all, to find part A, we have to go for t less than 0. That is, we need to find the values at 0 minus. So what will happen, or how will the circuit change at t minus 0? Number one, at t minus 0, the circuit is in stable condition, a steady state condition. Therefore, the inductor will become short circuit. The capacitor will become open circuit. And there will be one more change here, this 3ut. Since ut, we know, let's see, ut is defined as this, that the value of ut is 0 for t less than 0. That means for t less than 0, ut will become 0, or this ut will become 0, so 3ut will become 0. So the current source will become 0, and this will be represented by an open circuit. And as we see in the next slide, for t greater than 0, ut will be 1, so 3 ut will become simple 3 ampere. So let's see the circuit. The current source has now become open circuited, as we mentioned, because it is zero. So the capacitor has become open circuited and the inductor has become short circuited. Now, to find IL0, first we need to find IL0 minus. This is the circuit, and if you look at this circuit, this is the only source present now, and this source is not connected with any part. You can see if you go like this, there is a break here. If you go like this, there is a break here. So no current is flowing through this. So from the circuit, straight away we can say that IL0 minus is equal to 0. Then we come to VC0 minus. It is always better to take help of the KVL when writing the capacitor voltage. So we'll take this circuit, this loop here, and write KVL. So start from here, minus 20 minus VC equal to 0, minus 20 minus VC equal to 0, and therefore VC is equal to minus 20. So we get VC 0 minus equal to minus 20. And now look at R, this is VR here, and since there is no current flowing, therefore this voltage VR will also be 0. So we can write VR 0 minus equal to 0. So we have found the three terms for 0 minus, and now let's proceed to find for 0 plus. Now to find for 0 plus, we'll just use the condition, draw the circuit for t greater than 0, that is the transient period. As I mentioned in the previous slide, that this 3ut will be multiplied by 1, so it will become 3 ampere. And since we are in the transient period, therefore the capacitor will remain there and inductor will also remain there. So this is the circuit during the transient period. Two of the conditions we already know to find. Now we know that IL0 is equal to IL0 minus, because the inductor current and the capacitor voltage cannot change abruptly. So, and IL0 was 0, therefore IL0 plus will be 0. Similarly, VC0 plus is equal to VC0 minus, which was minus 20. So we have found these two terms. Now we need to find VR0 plus. Now how do we find VR0 plus, this voltage here? These are the values given. So for V0 plus, we take help of this mesh, this loop. But for that, we need to define the voltage across 4 ohm. So let's call it V0. So this voltage is V0. And now we write the KVL equation in the mid mesh here. So we start from here, minus VR plus V0 plus VC plus 20. Minus VR plus V0 plus VC plus 20, and all are for 0 plus. And now from here you can see VC0 is minus 20, VC0 minus is minus 20, and in the previous slide we found VC0 also to be equal to minus 20, so we'll plug in that value. So VC0 plus was minus 20, so we plug in here. So minus 20 and plus 20 will get cancelled, and therefore we can say that minus VR plus V0 is equal to 0, and from here we get VR0 plus equal to V0 plus. Now we need to find the value of VR in some numerical form, so we have to calculate the value of V0 plus. And how do we do that? We take help of now KCL. KCL at node A. If you see, the current 3 ampere is coming here, and one path for current is this one, and other is this way. So 3 ampere is equal to VA over 2, this is the voltage at node A, so VA over 2, and this voltage is VA minus VB divided by 4, this current, so VA minus VB divided by 4 is the current through 4 ohm resistance. Now VA is actually VR and VA minus VB is V naught, so we'll plug in the values. So for VA we write VR0 plus, or for VA minus VB we write V0 plus. Now we'll use this, that V0 plus is actually VR0, so from we'll plug VR0 at this place. So VR0, both now VR0, so we can calculate VR0 from here to be 4 volt. So we have found the third term, and since V0 plus is also equal to VR0, therefore V0 plus is also equal to 4 volt. So these are the three terms that we have found now for part A. IL0, VC0 plus minus 20, VR0 plus 4 volt. Okay, now let's move to part B. In this we have to find DIL dt, DV dt, DVC dt and DVR dt. So to find the first one, that is DIL dt, we'll use the formula VL equals LDI dt. So VL equals LDI dt, and from here we can find di dt is equal to VL over L, and we are adding the zero positive sign. So if we can find VL, then we can find di dt, and VL is here, so we'll take help of this loop, we'll write KVL equation. So by writing the KVL, we're starting from here, minus 20 minus VC plus VL equal to 0, minus 20 minus VC plus VL equals to 0, so VL is equal to VC plus 20, and VC0 plus we have already found from here, VC0 plus is minus 20, so we plug in minus 20 here, so the net result is 0, that means VL0 plus is equal to 0, and that means DIL dt will also be 0, because if this term is 0, then the whole term becomes 0. So this is the first part. Now to find DVC dt, we'll use the formula for IC. We know IC is C dV dt. So IC is C dV dt, or DVC dt is equal to IC over C. So if you know IC, we can find the answer. IC is in this branch. So if you take the KCL here, current entering is equal to current leaving. So let's write that equation. So KCL at node B, current entering is V0 plus divided by 4, this is V0 divided by 4, and current leaving is IC and IL, IC and IL. IL 0 plus we already know is equal to 0 from here, so we plug in that value, IL 0 plus is equal to 0, and V0 plus was 4, we have found from the previous slide, so plug in that value, therefore IC 0 plus is equal to 1 ampere. And so now we can find the DVC dt by plugging in the value of IC and plugging in the value of C. So it will be 2 volts per second. Now we need to find DVR dt. So for dvr dt, if you see it is here in this loop, so we'll write the loop equation. So by writing KVL, minus Vr plus V naught plus Vc plus 20, minus Vr plus V naught plus Vc plus 20 equals 0. So Vr is equal to V0 plus Vc plus 20. And now if we differentiate this, so taking differential, we get dVr dt equal to dvc dt and dv0 dt. Now dvc dt we just found from the previous slide, so we'll plug in the value of that, which was 2. So we plug in the value of, so this is our equation number 8.2.11. we still need to find dv0 dt. So how to find this? Now we'll look at this circuit again, and we'll take help of KCL at node A. So let's write KCL at node A. 3 ampere entering and leaving is VR over 2 and V0 over 4. So VR over 2 and V0 over 4. And simplifying this, we get this. And now we differentiate it again. So differentiating, we get this term, and from here we can write dv0 dt is equal to minus 2 dvr dt. Now we'll plug in this value here in this equation. So all terms will be now dvr. So plugging in this value here and taking them together, the dvr terms, we get dvr dt equals to 2 over 3 volts per second. So this completes part B. Now let's move on to part C. Here we have to find the three infinite values, IL infinity, VC infinity and VR infinity. Since the circuit is now in a steady state, so we'll open the capacitor and short the inductor. So this is the circuit. Now IL infinity is the current in this branch here, and you can see 3 ampere is dividing into two paths, one and on the right hand side. We need to find this current. So by current division rule, we can find the current IL, which is total current 3 ampere divided by total resistance multiplied by opposite arm. So this is the opposite arm for this branch. So the current IL infinity is 1 ampere. Next we have to find VC infinity. We again, don't forget, we have to take the help of KVL. So minus 20 minus VC equal to 0. Minus 20 minus VC equal to 0, therefore VC infinity is equal to minus 20 volt. So this is the second term. Now for VR infinity, we again take help of the KCL, but now we find current in this branch. So by same rule, current in this branch is total current divided by total resistance multiplied by opposite arms. So it is 2 ampere, and current multiplied by 2 ohm resistance here will give the VR infinity to be 4 volt. So I hope this gives you an understanding as to how to solve this type of a problem. Thank you.